dancing. I just see you dancing, man. Dancing easy and swift. Come on and give God praise. Oh, yes, he's getting ready for a new thing. He's getting ready for a new thing in your life. Hallelujah. You know what? I have to tell you that money is already here for you. It's already here. It's here. You might as well clap your hands and tell him thank you. God, just keep blessing this man. Something's lined up in heaven. When you line up in heaven, that's when you come down, man. Am I right about it? That's how you know God is doing. Because I'm going to be honest with you. Since I'm as mean as Jeff gets sometimes, I'm glad he do. Because since I've been listening to him, oh my God, thank God, I'm no longer that used to be Teresa. Serious. I'm so serious. I am so grateful that sometimes I don't even want to pick up the phone. Hallelujah! Come on, give God praise. Just give him praise. Give him glory. He's worthy. I mean, I know God said, if you praise him, first he said, enter into my gates for what? And my courts for what? I dare you to begin to praise him right now. Something big is getting ready to happen when you walk out here trying to say, your birthday is going to come yet. Roll out of sight. Yes, turn it around for her, God. Even with her children, God. Do it. Only you can do it. And it can be done because I know you can. In the name of Jesus, bless her right now, God. Have your way, Lord God. Put money in her hand, God. Run it in her feet, God. Hey. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for all you've done for us and all you're about to do. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, God. I feel the Holy Spirit. Worship the Lord. Just worship the Lord. I dare you to worship the Lord. Come on. That's what's wrong with the church. You don't want to worship him. You got to worship him. Come on, worship him. That's it, worship the Lord. That's it, worship him. Watch what happens. Just begin to worship him. Yokes are about to be destroyed. You will no longer be the same. God is taking you higher and higher and higher. Oh, yes. That's it, that's it. Let him have his way. That's it, that's it. Somebody get it, yeah. Go in, yeah. Come on, worship the Lord. I gave you the words of him. Come on, I feel something right now. I feel it. I feel it. I feel it. I feel it. Yes. Yes. Come on. I feel it. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, how loving Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Sing, oh, how I love Jesus.
Yes.
I'm singing, oh, how on, give God praise. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God is an awesome God. And we'll let the Holy Spirit in. I'm telling you, he's going to put something big in your mind. I dare you to get out of your flesh and just begin to worship him. That's it. That's right. That's right. You will never be the same. You can't even be the same when you go in your gaps. Just thank him right now. Yokes are being destroyed. Right now. Right now. That's right. Every spirit of jealousy got to go. Every spirit of hindrance got to go. That's right. Come on. Hallelujah. Just bless him. Bless him because he loved you. Bless him because he's been good to you. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We're going to go ahead and let Brother Howley come. He's going to come forth with his poem. After which, we're going to have Brother Kirk come with this by the way of a testimony or either by a word. And then we're going to have Connie, and then we're going to have Minister Terrence.
First off, give me honor to God, Pastor, Elder, and my children in our absence, and the body of Christ as a whole. I did a different approach to this because, well, different venue, but at the same time, the way I approached it and from what I've seen was transpired today, it was appropriate. The poem's called Overcoming, but then even in my own thought in preparing this, I would have to say overcoming the human condition. The word overcoming is a verb, and when I actually looked it up, it said overcome, overcame, and overcoming. Everybody know an action word is a verb. There's three definitions in the English, one in the Hebrew, and one in the Greek. One would be to get the better of in a struggle or a conflict with the enemy. To prevail over a weakness, to overpower or overwhelm in body or mind. The examples they gave was liquor, drugs, exertion, or even your own emotion.
Not sex.
That was the case.
In Hebrew, the word pronounced is yakol. The spelling is pronounced Yah, Kol. It's spelled Y-A-K-O-L. It's to prevail, to overcome, and or even to endure. In the Greek, we all wear the shoes, Nike. Yeah. Yeah, I was surprised myself. Nike. Or it can also be said, Nikao, N-I-K-A-O. It's all the words mean conquer, overcome, prevail, or subdue. Okay. Scriptures I used was James 1 and 2, Philippians 2:15, Matthew 28:20, Isaiah 41 and 10, Psalms 3 and 3, 1 Peter 1 and 23, 1 Peter 5 and 7. And it reads, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptation, for you are a child of light in a perverse and corrupt nation. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. So fear not, nor be dismayed. I will strengthen and help you with my righteous right hand, which shall be a shield for you, the glory that uplifts your head. Being born again of incorruptible seed through the word of God, which lives and abides forever, we must cast our cares upon him so that our days will be light as a feather. We're not only overcoming the world, but also the human condition. one way, no other way I know of to do that, but to stick to his plan and to fulfill our mission.
Isn't that a beautiful gift you have? Amen. Give God praise. You got better than that. Yeah, you got to encourage gifts. Amen. So when you get ready for your little gift, you don't want everybody to get up. Then you're right. When they don't get up, go home. Come on. You know what? He acting funny. No, you didn't get up for me. I ain't getting up for you. Okay. Render unto Caesar what's due to Caesar, and unto God what's due to God. Now this is due to God. So glad to see you, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. At this time, we're going to go ahead and bring Minister Kirk. Come on. You can come in your own way.
Grace and peace, everyone. Just first give an honor to God today. Give an honor to you, Pastor, to your husband, Elder Jeff, the entire First Family, my beautiful wife and children, and to all of you, the wonderful people of God as a whole. When she said to come with a word, the first word that came to my mind was unity. And I'm saying that, amen. And I'm saying that from the prayer that we had over the fall Friday. And the spirit of unity that we had on Thursday, it was so strong. I'm still thinking about that. And our transition of us moving, I just saw all the hearts of everyone, just like all the gifts that were being poured in, just the sacrifice, the humility, right. Just the hard work, right. And just everybody coming together, you know, moving things and just getting things done. And I was saying to myself, this is how it's supposed to be. You know, this is what the church is supposed to be, you know, helping each other, coming together, strengthening each other, being encouragement to each other. Because we all know, and sometimes we all need a hand or need help from someone. You know, man is not an island. You know, we can't do this, you know, do things, you know, just by yourself. You know, I mean, you know, we all, you know, don't want to be reliant or dependent on people and things like that. But we all are, you know, together, one body, one mind, one spirit, one accord, one body in Christ.
Hallelujah.
So I'm just really I'm just kind of using the words right now, but this is really beautiful. This is something I had never seen to this level of any church that I've been in, you know, over the years, even the church I grew up. This right here at Greater Works, this is how it's supposed to be. And I'm just glad that God is elevating us. I'm just thankful for God for that. Anyway, that's what I have for you. And I just pray for, you know, your strength in the Lord as you pray for mine.
Come on, y'all. Give God praise. Grace and peace to everyone. Truly, I give honor to this great God whom indeed I serve on today, who is indeed my life on today. I give honor to our beautiful pastor. I give honor to the elder. I give honor to the children. I give honor to the people of God that are here. Wow, as I just look back just over my life, I thought about a lot of things and reminisce about a lot of things. And I said, this place that I'm in right now is not the most comfortable place. And I have to truly say that. And I'm telling you, your testing and your trials will come and either make or break you. But I'm determined to walk with Jesus. I'm telling you, I'm determined to walk with Jesus. Yes, I believe. And I try to hide behind a smile and things like that. But you don't know half of what I know that I'm going through. But truly, I know it's God's strength. I'm not going in my own strength. Yeah, I know it's God, the strength of God. Yeah. And the song that comes to me is, if it had not been for him on my side, where would I be? I mean, going through losing my mom, not only losing my mom, and going just through a series of tests. But I know there's a scripture that comes to mind, in whatever state you find yourself in, there with to be content. So I'm content all today of Satan's a lie. He's already defeated. God has my future in his hand, and I know who holds my future. He also holds my hand. So I'm grateful on today. So if you don't see me smiling all the time, know that I love you with the love of God. Know that I love you with the love of God. I'm just going through just like the next one. But I know that God is indeed with me in spite of everything. He's with me. I thank God for the people of God. I have natural family, but it seems like I have none. And I'm going to be honest. Since my mom passed, I haven't heard from a one. So I know that it's indeed God that is with me, that he's keeping me. Well, Pastor, I love you so much. Words can't even express how much I love you. How much I love you and Elder, I'm telling you. You push us. Even a lot of times when we don't even want to go, you push us. And I am grateful to that. It's pushing me to the place God will have me to be. And I'm grateful. You pray for me as I pray for you. In Jesus' name.
Come on, let's give God praise. Yeah. My God. Come on, give God praise. Yeah. You don't know like what she felt. You know, and you know, I know how she feel. And because, you know, I was in a position like her, and I can remember being coming into church when I was sitting in the pulpit. I tell y'all that all the time. People thought because I had a smile on my face that everything was all right. And you know what? Folk beat me up worse when I was going through than I was through. Yeah. Isn't that terrible? That's why we got to learn to discern each other and have love and compassion to your brother. Because you don't know, it just might be the end of the rope that they hold on to. And you beat that phone and don't even know they one step away from walking away from God.
Yeah.
Somebody ought to praise me for her. My heart goes out to you because I know you're going to make it. I call and check on her. She knows that. I text her. I call her. I talk to her. I make sure it's my job to impart in her because I know the struggle. I've been there, done that, got a trophy and some t-shirts and still will go through. Because I know the one that holds my hand. He holds my feet. And you're going to get through this. And you're going to be able to step on top of the devil's head and tell the devil you're a liar. I made it through. Come on, somebody. Don't tell him I made it through.
Sit back and be mad at her and try to come some other way. Send some old joker. But that's okay. God got a real man of God in you. Come on. You see, honey, you pass the minister. Come on.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. I thank God for his goodness, his mercy, and his kindness. We thank God.